President Duterte wants all prisoners released on good conduct credits back in jail. The president has given them 15 days to surrender or register themselves with the Bureau of Corrections. Failure to do so means they will be considered fugitives from justice. At the same time, the president ordered the immediate resignation of Bucor Chief Nicanor Faeldon over the GCTA mess. Added details from Daniel Manalastas.
President Rodrigo Duterte has sacked Bureau of Corrections Chief Nicanor Faeldon in light of the issue of the Good Conduct Time Allowance Law and of the allegations against Faeldon releasing convicted criminals at the Bureau of Corrections. But on top of it, after the news came out of a possible release of convicted rapist murderer Antonio Sanchez, thereby pushing the president to make a tough decision.
Ito, I decided late last night, and my orders are, one, that I am demanding the resignation of Faeldon immediately. Second, that I am calling for an investigation to be handled by the ombudsman. I said no releases, but what he said was a computation. May apoy na nga eh. Okay. I was trying to provide the fire extinguisher. Para wala na maduda yung tao, no releases. Eh kung sinabi niya yan, di wala na sana. Ang ginawa niya, he tried to justify okay. Ang computation nila. Okay. Which may be correct, by the way. Hindi naman mabubo to eh. But the problem is, there was a fire burning. Pag sinabi ng Presidente, hintay ka until public orders. Ang ibig sabihin noon, mag-imbestiga ako in a jiffy. An investigation, sure, just ask persons about what really happened. Then I can make the decision.
The President insisted he's against the GCTA. He also ordered to re-arrest the criminals convicted of grave or heinous crimes who got their get-out-of-jail tickets courtesy of the GTA statute. They have 15 days to surrender, lest be treated as fugitives to be hunted down by law enforcement.
Then I would address myself, yung lahat na kulong at na-release sa batas na ito, 1,700 of you surrender and have yourself registered with the Bucor. If I were you, mag-surrender na kayo sa the nearest police or military detachment, wherever you are now, because I do not need to have a warrant.
President Duterte will leave it to the Office of the Ombudsman on possible sanctions that Faeldon may face, and so forth with other officials in the Bucor involved in the GCTA. The president added that he will suspend them for now, but will have to report to his office and to the office of the Department of Justice. Meanwhile, President Duterte maintains his trust on presidential spokesperson Salvador Panelo. President Duterte believes that Panelo just did his job in referring Sanchez's case to the proper government agencies.
Yung ginawa ni Panelo, it is not his fault that he was lawyering yan eh. Hanap buha namin yung mga, you cannot question that. And if he happens to be there because I appointed him, nag dumating sa kanya, in-refer niya sa the proper entity. Yun nga yung board. Panelo did not commit any infraction or... He happened to be a lawyer at the time. Nobody can question. Kaming mga abogado, kagaya ninyo, when it is part of your duty or function sa amin.
Daniel Manalastas for the Nation.